we talk about the blood vessels in the eyes when looking for an illness, especially you mentioned earlier when it comes to diabetes. Kind of walk us through, you know, what that may look like to you when you're looking at the back of the eye.
Yeah, so when we're looking in the back of the eye, we can see tons of blood vessels. And what's interesting is that a lot of the blood vessels inside your eye are similar in size to blood vessels that we would find in the kidneys.
You brought an example of what the healthy blood vessels should look like when you're looking inside the retina compared to somebody with diabetes. So what exactly are you looking at, Doc?
The first photo is of a healthy retina. It's actually my retina. And here you can see those red lines are my blood vessels, and they are healthy. They are doing their job transporting blood to the tissue. The next photo I have, you can see there's kind of some splotches of red around the blood vessels, and that's actually blood that is leaking out into the eye. There's also kind of some small wispy red lines, and that's the eye's attempt to grow new blood vessels, which sounds great initially, but those new blood vessels actually end up causing more problems in the long run.
We talked to you before about, you know, what happens with blurry vision. So people who are experiencing painful and blurry vision, those types of symptoms in your eye, why is it that that is something you really should get taken care of right away? It's not something to say, well, it'll just get better and let me just leave alone. You say, you know, get someone else to look at it.
One of the reasons is that some of these conditions are much easier to catch when they're actively happening. MS is a good example of this. So a lot of times a patient will come in and they'll have blurry vision and it'll be painful for them to move their eye. We'll take a look inside the eye and see that the nerve is very inflamed. And the follow-up question from there we ask is, have you been diagnosed with MS? And typically the patient will either respond yes, or sometimes it's often that they'll say, well, my neurologist suspects I have MS. And so that's what's interesting. Sometimes we're catching these things for the first time, or other times we're kind of confirming that that's likely what's happening.
Sure.
And Dr. Bridget, since we're living in COVID times, tell us how COVID sometimes can present as an eye infection.
Right. So just like COVID can affect all different parts of our body, it can also show up in the eyes. One of the typical ways that it can show up is via pink eye. So kind of red eyes, watery, irritated, light sensitive. We're also seeing reports, though, where it can affect the nerve in the form of inflammation, kind of similar to MS. So that can result in vision loss in one eye. And we're also seeing that in the same way that it can affect our blood vessels in our body, it can affect the blood vessels in our eye. And so we're also seeing vision loss from that as well. So if you're having issues with your eyes, especially if you think you have pink eye and you've maybe been exposed to someone with COVID, it's something that you need to consider and go get checked out.
Well, Dr. Bridget, thank you so much for joining us today with all this great information.
Thank you.